consolidation project. I'd like to turn this over to Mr. Greg Crossman and ask him if he wouldn't take us forward from that point and explain what this is all about.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, good afternoon. Let me go ahead and share my screen real quick. Can everyone see the PowerPoint presentation? Or can anyone see the PowerPoint presentation?
Yes.
Great. Okay, great. Well, I appreciate that. I'm assuming the audio is good too, so we'll just go ahead. If not, holler, please. Agenda item one, which is the only agenda item on the agenda today, is your consideration of resolution 2021-19, as Mr. Chairman said, which is for guaranteed maximum price, or GMP number two, for pipeline construction with Aiken Gardner Construction. He's our construction manager at risk associated with the Carefree Water Consolidation Project. We do have some representatives with us tonight that I'd like to introduce. We have Ken Kawamoto with Aiken Gardner, who's Aiken Gardner's pre-construction manager. We have Brian Freilich, who's Aiken Gardner's project manager. And we also have with us tonight Teresa Mackinnon, who's with Mac Pro Services. And she's our public outreach coordinator associated with the project. And I do appreciate the board getting together this close to Christmas, but this is an important item that we need to discuss and consider. So without further ado, we'll move into the discussion of this item. This next screen is just a refresher of the Carefree Water Consolidation Project. And as you all know, the purpose of the consolidation project is to transition the Carefree service area, or neighborhoods A, B, and C, which are shown in red on this map, transition these areas from the Cave Creek water system over to the Carefree Water Company system. I think the last time that we really discussed the construction of the pipeline portion of the project and project sequencing was back on at the September 7th meeting. And at that point, our strategy was to start in the northwest part of Carefree in the area of neighborhood C, and with pipeline construction, and then work our way to the southwest. We then transition from neighborhood C down to neighborhood B, and finally end up in neighborhood A. It wasn't too long after that meeting, and at that meeting we did approve GMP number one, which was for early procurement of pipeline and pipeline appurtenances. It wasn't too long after that meeting that I posed the question to the team, our professional team, which included our construction manager at risk, Aiken Gardner, our designer, CVL, who's also our construction administration and inspection firm, and also our independent cost estimator, ICE. I kind of posed the question to them, does a sequenced pipeline construction starting from the northwest moving into the southwest makes sense? And really the answer came back, probably not, that was not the most effective, efficient, and cost-effective way to construct the project. And that probably the best way to construct this project was a single pipeline GMP. What the team felt like were some of the benefits of doing it under a single pipeline GMP is one that allows our CMAR, construction manager at risk, Aiken Gardner, to optimize their use of their pipeline crews and their management of those pipeline crews. They can put on to, in working in Carefree, one crew, two crews, even maybe upwards of three or four crews working at pipelines at any one point in time. And in having those multiple crews work on pipelines then does optimize their management. It also allows us as the UCFD to focus on our high priority areas and to communicate those priorities with our CMAR, with Aiken Gardner, and see how that fits into their construction plan and their construction sequencing. Ultimately, we feel like a single pipeline GMP guarantees the timely transition of all of the customers within the Carefree service area, neighborhoods A, B, and C, so that some customers in certain areas, such as neighborhood A, don't have to wait for construction in, say, for example, neighborhoods B and C to be completed before we start transitioning them over. This kind of relook at the whole project and this hitting the pause button also allowed us to do some value engineering, which was always part of the Aiken Gardner pre-construction services contract. And what this did was we looked at it so that what we wanted to accomplish as far as our project goals is to transition the entire CSA, which again is neighborhoods A, B, and C, in the most cost-effective manner. And that's what our value engineering effort focused on. And so what we were able to do when we looked at it from a value engineering perspective was to focus on the pieces of the project that were most important, and then either defer or delay portions of the project, which really weren't that critical and maybe just added cost to the project. So I think overall, we've ended up with a better, more efficient, more effective project to go under, do most of the pipeline work under one GMP. Some specifics of GMP number two, again, our contractor is the CMAR, the construction manager at risk for a water consolidation project, which is Aiken Gardner Construction. The cost for this GMP2, which again is the bulk of the work under the water consolidation project, is just over $9.4 million. It's $9,419,012.99 to be exact. The time to complete this GMP is 9 months from notice to proceed, and we expect notice to proceed to be issued around, but no earlier than February 1st. And that would put the start of construction around the February 15th timeframe. Some additional specifics about GMP number two, as far as pipeline work, about just over 3,850 lineal feet of pipeline will be constructed within neighborhood A. Just under 5,500 lineal feet of pipeline will be constructed in neighborhood B, just over 5,000 lineal feet in neighborhood C, and then along Tom Darlington and Carefree Highway, there'll be just about 9,600 lineal feet of pipeline construction. So all said and done, some total of all of those pipeline projects is just under 24,000 lineal feet of pipeline work, which is about 4.5 miles of pipeline construction. So a significant amount of construction included under this GMP number two. In addition to this linear pipeline work, there'll be additional work at 26 dispersed locations throughout Carefree and the Carefree service area. Those will be locations where we either need to disconnect the Carefree service area from the Cave Creek water system or reconnect the Carefree service area to the Carefree Water Company system. An important thing to note about GMP number two is that number that was presented, the $9.4 million, does not include any contingencies, but there will be contingencies and a contingency fund that will be needed for the project. It's just going to be held by the UCFD in our separate fund, as opposed to being included in the contract amount. And some of the things that we know we'll need the contingency fund for, we just don't know how much we'll need out of the contingency fund. And these are just some examples. Hard dig and rock excavation. We don't know how much hard dig and rock excavation we'll run into. We just know that we're in Carefree. We're butted up against the mountains in the north part of the Phoenix Valley. There is going to be some hard dig and rock excavation that will require some contingency funds. Off-duty police officers through signalized intersections. We don't have a lot of signalized intersections in Carefree. In fact, we don't have any in Carefree. We will be impacting one signalized intersection at Tom Darlington and Carefree Highway. It's a Scottsdale signalized intersection. At this point in time, we don't know if they're going to require us to have an off-duty police officer. If they do, it'll require some contingency funds. We have two jack and bore locations on the project where we're jacking and boring under culverts that go under the road. We don't know what the soil conditions are exactly like directly under those two culvert locations. If there's poor soil stability, we might need to use some contingency funds to get those jack and bores accomplished. Material escalations. Aiken Gardner and the team has done a great job at trying to control the volatility in that market. We approved GMP number one, which was early pipe procurement, to control material escalations and that volatility. It doesn't mean we've been able to control all of our material prices 100%. So there could be some material escalations that we need to utilize contingency funds for. And then as with any underground construction project where you can't see everything that's underground, there's going to be unforeseen conditions. There's going to be unknown conduits, unknown pipelines. We just didn't know were there that we might need to use contingency funds for. Typically for a project of this size, magnitude, complexity, and for where we're at in the design process that the GMP was based around, we would include 10 to 15% contingencies, which puts us in the $1 million to $1.5 million range. So again, we don't know how much of those contingencies we'll need to use. We just know that there will be some need for contingencies on the project. So, a question that we get a lot, and I know that you as the board and the council will be getting, is where will this construction start and when will it impact my neighborhood? Unfortunately, I don't have answers to those questions right now. Right now, it is somewhat of an open slate, but I do know that we will be spending a good portion of January planning our project sequencing with the team, being us at the UCFD here, our construction manager at risk with Aiken Gardner, our designer, who's also our construction administration and inspection firm, CVL, even our ICE team, our independent cost estimators, will all be getting together, figuring out what's the best way to construct this project and how should we be approaching it and tackling it. There's going to be items that get clearer as we move into January that will have an impact on that, on how we stage construction and sequence construction. That's the availability of staging areas, labor and crew availability from Aiken Gardner's perspective and how we can sequence these crews. Permit issuance, we have four plan sets that this GMP is based around that are in for plan permitting right now. So when those permits are issued will be important to when we can start construction. And then our UCFD priorities. What are our priorities on the project? How do we want to get this phased? And what makes the most sense for us as the UCFD? Just do know that public outreach has been included in these construction contracts, and that is an important part of our project, and it is an ongoing effort. Our next slide kind of deals with some of our thought processes on public outreach. This top part of this slide shows you a flyer that has gone out to all of the customers within the Carefree Water Company service area. Right now, it went out in November's water bill that went out in early December. The same flyer will go out to all of the residents within the Carefree service area, all the residents within neighborhoods A, B, and C before the end of the year, along with our water conservation flyer that's going out to everybody. The left side of this flyer is fairly simple flyer, but it does give everybody an idea of how we're intending to communicate with our residents. The left side of this flyer shows you a new website that we've developed specifically for the water consolidation project. It's carefree WCP, which stands for waterconsolidationproject.com. It will be the website that has up-to-date information on what's happening and what's and anything associated with construction of the water consolidation project. You can see right under that email or that website address, we also have a construction hotline that people will be able to call if there's any real significant and immediate issues associated with the construction project. I think it is operating right now, but since there's no real construction going on, there hasn't been a lot of activity on it, but it'll be another way for our residents to communicate with us on the project team. On the right-hand side of this flyer, it talks about Carefree's website, carefree.org, and also gives people instructions on how to sign up for the Carefree newsletter, which will be another way that we can send out information in a news blast to Carefree residents and let them know on immediate things that they might need to know about and what's happening associated with the water consolidation project. There also will be a link on Carefree's website back to the carefreewcp.com website in case people want to immediately go to that website. And there's a lot of good information already out on the Carefree website dealing with the history of the water consolidation projects. A lot of good resources here that we've thrown out to the community. So we talked about the specific project website, the town website with a link to the project specific website, the town newsletter. Of course, when we get into construction in specific areas, we will have a plan to communicate with residents in those areas, whether it's via flyer, mail outs, communication with HOAs. Typically, homeowners associations have their own sub email list so they can get email blasts out to their residents. So that's all part of our communication plan and our plan to reach the public when we do start construction. So with that, just a summary of our requested action tonight. It is to approve resolution 2021-19, which authorizes Chairman Peterson to execute construction contract C 2021-07 with our CMAR, Aiken Gardner, for GMP number 2, which is for the bulk of pipeline construction work associated with the water consolidation project in an amount of approximately $9.4 million. With that, I'd open it up to any questions that the board might have. And after questions, a possible motion would be simply be to move to approve resolution 2021-19 as presented. So with that, I'll open it up to questions that the board might have, and then we can go from there.
This is John, Craig. So one question about contingencies. So there's a good, based on the things which may cause us to dip into the contingency bucket, there's a good chance that we'll have to do that, at least to some degree. So does that come back before the board when that happens for approval or consideration?
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Vice Chairman, members of the board, that is something that won't necessarily have to come back to the board, but depending on the board's preferences, we can bring those items back to the board. It's something I probably need to talk to Chairman Peterson about how we want to communicate the use of contingencies back to the board. Typically, small use of contingencies up to a certain dollar limit don't come back to the board. So we'll probably have to come up with some processes that the board and that Mr. Chairman would like to see to communicate those the use of those contingencies. What we don't want to do is hamstring ourselves, but I'm sure the board is interested in, you know, in the use of those contingencies. So we will need to develop some processes and procedures and some notifications in how we're using those contingencies.
I think that's right, Greg. My first inclination to recommend to the council on that is that for small ones, we give an automatic authority to the group and Greg in particular to proceed if we get into what I would call intermediate level overruns on something or problem areas. Perhaps it's to advise the board on a frequent basis what we're doing. And if we get into what I would call large ones, then we then come back for specific approval. But let Greg and I and Gary and others talk about that, and we'll come back to you with something there. But I agree with Greg. Let's not hamstring ourselves that we have to hold back construction, because we want construction to flow smoothly and quickly, and to get this done as rapidly as we can and as efficiently as we can.
I agree with that, Les, absolutely. Greg, you in the presentation, you define it as a single pipeline system. I assume that the way this is being laid out, there is measures of redundancy all the way through for all three neighborhoods. That's question number one. Number two, I noticed that Section C had the largest quantity of linear feet, and I was curious as to, was that because of there's a greater lack of infrastructure there, and that's the cause of that, or is it because of the distance between C and B that causes the additional need for linear footage for the connection?
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, there is redundancy to answer your first question. There is redundancy factored into all of the neighborhoods, which is kind of normal for water systems. There are different levels of redundancy factored in. And, you know, as in, you know, water operators love to have redundancy. The more redundancy we have, the better. But we just can't factor in the world. So we have to, at some point, live with what we can afford to do. But we do have redundancy factored into these pipeline systems. And I'm sorry, what was your second question again?
Well, so it's essentially one large line that goes all the way down and connects all three.
Oh, why neighborhood C has the largest amount of pipeline. We do have to interconnect the upper part of neighborhood C with our north system, which is fed by our Silver Saddle water storage reservoir. That required a fairly significant pipeline down Rising Sun Road, which is, I think, is almost a mile worth of pipeline, maybe 3/4 of a mile of pipeline. That definitely is added into the overall pipe length. We had some pipeline along Scopa Trail where Cave Creek has really shut off a segment of pipeline that we weren't comfortable in taking over that piece of pipeline. So we're having to replace that pipeline because we don't know exactly why Cave Creek shut off that part of the pipe system in Scopa Trail. They've been able to feed it from different directions. But actually, when you look at it and when you consider that neighborhood A is fed by the Tom Darlington Carefree Highway pipeline, really a lot of the pipeline is focused on also on neighborhood A. So there is a lot of pipeline improvements for all of the neighborhoods that are needed.
Okay.
Any further questions, comments? A lot of work, a lot of decisions already made, a lot to be made yet.
Yeah, I have a comment I'd like to make. I think, Greg, you guys have done a great job, your team, working through what has been difficult circumstances. And I think having the CM at risk process has really lent itself to what we have faced and will face going forward. So thank you to everybody to get this to this point. Obviously there's a lot of work left to be done, but this is a big step forward.
Oh, it's huge. Yeah, a lot of work. Nice job, Greg.
Yeah. Yeah. No, thank you, board members.
Anything further? Hearing no further questions or comments, I would accept a motion to approve resolution 2021-119 or -19, authorizing the town or the UCFD to enter into a construction services contract C2021-07 with Aiken Gardner Construction.
I will submit that resolution. Les?
Thank you. Is there a second?
A second.
Motion has been made and seconded. Any further discussion or questions? Hearing none, Candace, would you please do a roll call?
You're muted, Candace.
You're muted, Candace.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you.
Board Member Geiger, how do you vote?
Aye.
Board Member Croyer, how do you vote?
Aye.
Board Member Johnson, how do you vote?
Aye.
Board Member DeLisio, how do you vote?
Aye.
Board Member Hatcher, how do you vote?
Aye.
Vice Chairman Crane, how do you vote?
Aye.
And Chairman Peterson, how do you vote?
Aye.
That's 7-0.
Okay, thank you all. The motion passes. Our best wishes for a smooth and trouble-free project. And we'd like to get rolling on this as quickly as we can. Go on to item number 2, adjournment. Is there a motion? All those in favor, please raise their hand. Aye. Okay, thank you.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Thank you, board. Merry Christmas, everybody. Happy New Year.
Well done, Greg.
Thanks, Greg. Nice work.
Thank you.
Greg, have a great week. Have a great week.